Ashok says, then Neeraj can start.
Okay, so we are live. We can go ahead.
Neeraj.
Yes. So good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the first Physio TV webinar hosted by Sancheti Hospital and Sancheti Healthcare Academy. I welcome today's guest speaker, Dr. Ali Irani, our panelist, Dr. Vivek Kulkarni sir, Dr. Aparna Sadle ma'am, and our chairman of Sancheti Group, Dr. Parag Sancheti sir. On the occasion of World Physiotherapy Day, we have proudly launched Physio TV. It is an online channel to broadcast physiotherapy webinars, conferences, telecasts, orations, skill demonstrations, CPEs, and workshops by eminent national as well as international faculties. We will be broadcasting the sessions for the physiotherapist by the physiotherapist. So today, on this auspicious day, today we will have first Physio TV webinar. And this on this occasion, today we have eminent speaker Dr. Ali Irani sir. Okay, so today before that, I will request Dr. Parag Sancheti, chairman of Sancheti Institute, to kindly enlighten us to his wisdom. Parag sir, over to you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Neeraj. Good afternoon, everybody. It's indeed a great pleasure that today the Physio TV is being launched, and today is the first webinar, first ever webinar of the Physio TV, and we have nobody else than the famous Dr. Ali Irani, who is going to run the first webinar. Professor Ali Irani and Sancheti Hospital go a long way. He has been a complete supporter from the beginning, from the inception of our college, and has always, you know, showed us the way. So, Professor Ali Irani, we are so much thankful to you. He's a very busy person. He is heading all the activities at the Nanavati Hospital. And as all of us know, his claim to fame was when he was the physiotherapist was of the Indian cricket team. And he still has very strong connections with the cricket team as well as Bollywood, just in case you don't know. So, thank you, Professor Irani, for joining us today. Before we proceed, I just want to quickly, you know, tell you a little bit about the background of this Physio TV. So there is, similar to Physio TV, there is something called as the Ortho TV and Anesthesia TV, which has successfully been launched by the Indian Orthopedic Research Group chairman, Dr. Ashok Shyam. And Dr. Ashok Shyam has started this TV called Physio TV. It will work on the similar lines of Ortho TV, which has 25,000 plus orthopedic surgeons subscribing to it. More than 6,000 anesthetists are subscribing to the Anesthesia TV. And I'm sure with the sheer size of the physiotherapist in the country, it will not take time for this platform to take off. Just to put things in perspective, the Indian Association of Orthopedic Surgeons has a strength of 12,500 members. And I have been told that the IAP, that is the Indian Association of Physiotherapists, has more than 50,000 members. So, you know, it's already four times bigger than the Orthopedic Association. So, Ashok, you will have a lot of work at hand, and you are going to spend more sleepless nights than you've ever spent. So, please be ready for that challenge. And knowing Professor Irani, he will always keep you on your toes. So, thank you so much. I don't want to take much time, but want to thank all the members of Sancheti College of Physiotherapy, especially Principal Vivek Kulkarni, Associate Professor Apurva Shimpi, and coordinators for today's program, Dr. Neeraj Athawale, Dr. Aparna, Dr. Nilima Bedekar, Dr. Mansi, and last but not the least, Rahul Chobe for coordinating everything. So without much ado, Dr. Ashok and team, I want to best wish all the best for Physio TV. And I'm sure on this auspicious occasion of Ganesh Chaturthi, which is today, and the end of Pitru Paksha, Physio TV will grow by leaps and bounds under your leadership, Ashok. All the best. And thank you very much. And Professor Irani, thank you for joining.
Thank you very much, Parag sir, for your kind words. Now, we will proceed to the today's session. Now, I will request, I will just introduce today's panelist, Dr. Vivek Kulkarni sir. He is a principal of Sancheti College of Physiotherapy, He has done various research work in his neurophysiotherapy. Today, our second panelist is Dr. Aparna Sadle, ma'am. She is the principal of DES Brijlal Jindal College of Physiotherapy. And also, she has a very great experience of 28 years of experience in teaching. Also, currently, she is the working member in MSOTPT as well as Senate member in MUHS. Welcome, ma'am. Today, our guest, Dr. Ali Irani, sir. I will request Dr. Aparna Sadle, ma'am, to introduce Dr. Ali Irani, sir.
So before that, I also wish to welcome Dr. Aparna Sadle. She has tremendous experience, and I'm sure she's going to add a lot of value to today's webinar and help all the viewers increase their knowledge about brain mapping. So thank you very much, Dr. Aparna Sadle, for joining. Over to the introduction of Professor Irani.
Over to Aparna, ma'am.
Thank you, Parag Sanjeti, sir, and Neeraj, for your kind words. Before I start introducing, I would like to congratulate Vivek Kulkarni, sir, Dr. Parag Sancheti, sir, and Sancheti team for the launch of Physio TV. I would also like to thank organizers of today's webinar for inviting me as the panelist. Now, before we start, I would like to introduce Dr. Ali Irani, who is the eminent physiotherapist. Sir did his bachelor's in physiotherapy from MS University, Baroda. He then got his PhD in sports medicine, PhD in anatomy of body movement, dance from Bombay University. He then got his doctor of physiotherapy from NUMS, Spain. He currently is head of department of physiotherapy and sports medicine at Rehabilitation Center, Nanavati, Super Speciality Hospital, Mumbai. He also is chairman of International Affairs, Indian Association of Physiotherapists, and also is principal of NMIMS University. He has very varied experience to his credit. He has been physiotherapist for Indian cricket team from 1987 to 1997. He is member of Board of Studies of NMIMS University. He has worked as researcher at Bombay Hospital from 1985 to 86. He has presented various papers on knee mobility, backache, hammer tone for frozen shoulder, fitness and sports injuries, and held workshops on innovative physiotherapy and sports medicine at various national and international conferences. He has always been invited for various physiotherapy and medical colleges for different events. He has conducted workshop for Iranian Physiotherapy Association in 2004 and again in February 2005. Sir has helped to set up physiotherapy and rehabilitation center in Bhuj, Gujarat for earthquake victims. He has been examiner and lecturer for students of Masters of Fine Arts at Bombay University. He has been PhD guide at various universities in India. He also has held lectures on disaster management along holding rural physiotherapy camps for community-based rehabilitation. Sir has been awarded with Hitra Oration Award in 1994 for achievements made in the field of physiotherapy. Sir is also a recipient of Lifetime Achievement Award by Indian Association of Physiotherapy in 2004. He was awarded fellowship by Indian Association of Sports Medicine in 2005. He has also been awarded fellowship by Indian Association of Physiotherapists in 2005. He has been awarded Best Citizens of India Award in 2011. And he's also won Physiotherapist Award in India from Medscape in 2014. Sir is member of various organizations, to name a few. He is patron member of Indian Association of Physiotherapists. He is life member of Indian Association of Sports Medicine. Sir has been, or is rather, is vice president of Bombay District Sports Medicine Association. He is vice president of Bombay Suburban Amateur Athletic Association. He is also a member of Gujarat Physiotherapy Council and a member of Maharashtra Occupational Therapy and Physiotherapy Council. So we know that we have such an eminent speaker amongst us for today's first webinar. And I'm sure all the audience and the other members are going to love his speech. Over to you, Neeraj.
Thank you, Aparna ma'am. Now I would like to request Dr. Ali Irani sir to kindly carry the session.
Thank you.
Over to you, sir.
Respected Dr. Parag and Dr. Sancheti the Great Senior, please give my regards to him. He's not there. Thank you, all those who are on board and panelists today. Thanks, Dr. Aparna, for your kind words. Thank you, Dr. Parag, for your kind words. You know very well, it's never very difficult to say no to Sancheti, whatever it is and whatever they are doing, I'm there. Thank you, Apurva and Dr. Kulkarni. Thank you, Dr. Ashok, for assembling all this. I'm very happy to know that, again, Sancheti has become the first person to think about television, and it's going to be called Physio TV. Definitely, it will go a long way, especially we have got more than 20,000 students all over the country. So your programs will definitely help, and a lot of say will be there. I want to put a lot of inputs. I'll be talking to Apurva, Kulkarni, Ashok, Dr. Ashok, and definitely Dr. Parag, what all could be done and how we could take it globally. So when the topic came that it will be the first webinar on Physio TV, I thought of a topic which will be very close to my heart and something different. So it will be something new for all the physiotherapists watching today, and definitely whenever it will go on YouTube and remain on YouTube. So I decided the topic to be as physiotherapy and brain mapping. So the physiotherapists no more treat patient physically from giving exercises and movements. And physiotherapists no more only giving diathermy and ultrasound. So we have entered a patient's brain. So we can read the brain now. As I always say, a tongue can lie, but a brain cannot. So we understand the brain of a patient better now. And that's going to help us. That's our topic of the day. Thank you for inviting me, all of you, all the panelists, especially Dr. Sancheti and Dr. Parag. Thanks a lot. And I'll do my best, whatever I can, for Physio TV. So we go ahead with our screen. Can we go to that first one? Yeah. I very strongly believe that there is no proof that we are going to come to this world again and again. But what we have come today, we are very sure that we have come to this world and we will be in this world only once. So what good we can do and how we shall be remembered is going to be very important. So let the world remember us in one of the best way. And that is doing good. And physiotherapy is in a healing profession. We heal. We get smile on patient's face. So that's how we start our topic today. And it's going to be brain mapping in physiotherapy. So physiotherapy is no more giving diathermy and ultrasound. We are again one step ahead, and it's going to be how to enter the patient's brain. This is how, if you go and see, everybody has two sides of the brain, the left and right. And as you all know, the left has a lot of calculation, mathematics, and logical speaking. And right has got more to do with imagination. So I always put it, I divide it in two ways. The right side is more like a female brain, multitasking. They can do many things at one time. And the left will be more of a male brain. You know, they are into the box. They will only go to finish that work, come out, then enter to the next work. They cannot do multitasking the way the females can do it. And both of us have the right and the left. This is how, I want to just explain you all what is EEG, right? So please let's understand. The old EEG machine used to look like that. There are tiny electrochemical impulses of varied frequencies, which are measured in hertz, that is cycle per seconds. how many cycle per second. And they are registered the way we have ECG, which we do the cardiogram. The way we do the cardiogram ECG, the impulses from the brain are registered as EEG. And you see it very simply, whatever you have been seeing on the three impulses, hertz that you are seeing. The first one, we could say that it's, I'm going to explain them. It's going to be the gamma zone, beta zone, and that's the alpha zone, less frequencies per second. So let us introduce to you what is brain. It consists of 20 billion neurons, which generates electrical impulses. Combination of this electrical activity is called as brain wave pattern, as it is a cycle-like wave in nature. Now, we have a software which will be converting this small brain waves, whatever you will be seeing, we will be, the average will be shown in a mushroom form. These are measured and analyzed through electroencephalography called EEG. Now, brain wave can be measured as a frequency of cycle per second, which is called hertz. So what do we use for it? Very simple. It's a very small portable two-channel portable EEG, not like the big units what you saw on the first slide. It can be just kept next to the face of the patient, next to the patient, or if you are giving it in sitting position, it can be held by the patient. Now, through Bluetooth, these frequencies can go to the laptop. And there's a software in the laptop which registered this. And we have a electrode, you could see the electrode which could be put on the forehead, because our thinking activities is from the forehead. That's why when sometimes we don't remember, we are banging our head, right? So we take the three electrodes on the forehead. It's stuck by the Velcro and it is buttoned, and the buttons go to the portable EEG. And it allows simple visual analysis of the activity. Now, we started it with sports people, because being in sports for a long year, I wanted more to first understand the working system of a sports brain. So majority of our work is done on sports, but we have got two units. We have another unit, which is for neurological condition. So my first passion is sports. And then we have also worked on the neurological conditions. And I hope the way brain mapping will enter in all the colleges and schools of physiotherapy, we will be able to work more on different type of patients. At present, we will see mostly what work has been done has been on sports people, but we have done on normal college going students also. Next. Fine. So let's... Please understand the zones, how our brain are divided. So when you are in a delta zone, it is less than 4 hertz. The activity of your brain is less than 4 hertz. And once it goes above 4 hertz, up to 7 hertz, it's theta. So I would say 4, you are asleep, and theta, you are semi-conscious. You're just getting up, right? That could be 4 to 7. And once you are in alpha 8 to 12, you are fully conscious, and it's one of the best zone. As I'll be talking on different slides, you will come to know how alpha is the zone of living. I wish everybody could always remain in alpha. And then comes the beta zone. Beta is also subdivided into, you know, medium beta and high and low. So it's low, medium and high beta. Subdivided, and then we have the gamma, which goes from 29 hertz to 40 plus. It could go to any amount after 40. So this, please understand that our brain is in 5 zones at present. A lot of work, a lot of research is still going on the gamma zone, because gamma is now, as slides come, you will understand more, but I will go one by one on each of these zones. So let us first understand how it will look. So when we do a brain mapping, that what you saw, the small portable EEG, it goes to a software on a Apple pad, and the average is taken. The average impulses of hertz, when the average comes, it will be in a mushroom form. So what you are seeing now, this is how it's going to be displayed. It's a slide. It's not a movie. I will be showing you the videos also. So it gets converted into a mushroom. So the prominency of the herds are known. And they represent where you are, in which zone you are. So extreme left is delta zone, then becomes theta zone, then alpha zone. Then it will be beta and gamma. That's a video. So just a normal brain mapping. So whatever you see, that mushroom, they are the prominent. So what can you, as you are seeing it, a normal activity that is going on. So extreme right is not there. So the patient is not in gamma. You could think of more about where you are still into delta and theta zone. Right? A few things come on the right side, which has to do with gamma zone. So let me first explain you the characteristics of these zones. We have spoken about the five zones. So I'll only take the prominent one. So in delta, it's a deep sleep. You are literally deep sleep and you are surviving. Theta is more to do with dreams. You could say that you could, during your dream and you're seeing dreams, you are in theta zone. But it is alpha that you are fully focused. You are fully focused, and it is also a healing zone. I don't know how many remember, there was a matrix conference on matrix machine in Pune, and I had come. And one of the things that we had researched was when matrix, application of matrix was applied to sports people or any patient, the patient did go in alpha zone. The frequency of the brain was going around 8 to 10 hertz, which was an alpha zone. Very interestingly, we'll come to know also most of the sportsmen who perform very well, if you tell them to imagine about the best game they have played, they are in alpha zone. So idea of how brain mapping will help is, if you get your patient in alpha zone, the healing will be faster, the treatment will be more accurate and will be definitely affecting the patient. Then we have the beta zone, which is a lot of excitement, stress, anxiety, fear, and rage. Now, there are too many things common between beta and gamma and between gamma and beta zone. So no doubt, gamma is also present when you are awaking, right? And gamma also means too many thoughts. Right, and a lot of research is still going on it. So with some slides, I'll be able to tell you the new thing that we are finding out in gamma zone. But we are very sure about the best zone to live is the alpha zone. We'll talk about all the zones a little more. So I'm on the first zone, which is the delta zone. So if you see it, this is how it will look. Sorry, because all the in video, I can't be showing you how prominent it looks. So we have taken the average and it's a slide. We take it in a slide form for a student to understand a little better. But this delta zone, you are in deep sleep, right? And you can also experience this in those who are doing meditation, right? Also, meditation brings you in delta zone. The next is the theta zone. This is how it will look. So we are more than 4 hertz, between 4 and 7 hertz. So we are not between 0 to 4 hertz, which was in delta. So we just move from 4 to 7. And that's how this, how it will look. Right? And I'll take the next, alpha. Yes. Now this is the most important zone, which crosses 8 hertz to 12 hertz. Definitely, it is healing. And during alpha, your thoughts are positive. You're well aware. It's also awareness and enhanced focus. And please see next with down. This is how the ECG will show in the pattern. If you can see this ECG pattern, it will be showing like that. But we have a software which converts it when we want to do the slides, which converts it into the mushroom. The peaks are picked up. And it shows it like that. So very easy to know that the patient or your sports people is in alpha zone, theta zone, or delta zone. And EEG will pick up like what you are seeing it down. Come to the beta zone. See the down part, what you are seeing on ECG, it will be looking like this. So please understand, it's high complex. See where it is wavering. You can see the mushrooms. It's how it is wavering all over. Right, it's a high complex mental functioning. It is associated with strong excitement and emotion, which could be fear, anxiety, attention, concentration, anticipation, and it's also found in hypertension. So it's a very complex zone where you are out of focus. So we have found out. Sorry, just finish the gamma and okay. It's also found when a person is not performing. Let me give a very simple example. We did randomly on young students. We just asked them to think about they are enjoying with their friends. And they were all in alpha zone because they were enjoying with their friends. And suddenly we spoke to them about exams. As soon as you talk about exam, they go in gamma zone or high beta. Right? That means immediately the concentration goes away. They are tense. Right? So this is we find, like when you are doing brain mapping, you can just shift the zone by your thoughts, right? That's our biggest scare about using this very regularly is the police, because they know we can find out whether the person is really a criminal or not, right? It's so accurate on it. You can come to know if that person has done that crime, because when you are talking to that person, you will ask him the person's name. So he will be on the, if he's telling his true name, the frequency will be different than when he's telling a lie. That's how we catch. So you have to push on him. Okay, you have murdered, you have killed that person, right? So how he responds on the reading, we come to know whether he's telling the truth or he's lying. Come to the gamma. Yes. Now there's a lot of studies that is going on, but just look at the down part. See the ECG part of gamma zone. See how many frequencies, how many cycles per second. It's almost more than 40 per second. Now here the patient is, or the person whom we are doing the brain mapping is in an awake state, but too many thoughts. It's also seen in anxiety. And in short, the person cannot focus on one thing. And a lot of new researches are going on because we are finding this gamma zone. I'll be coming to the slide to see in what other conditions we can find gamma zone. A lot of studies still going on in gamma zone. We are not coming on accuracy. But in short, when I have spoken to the sports people, when I've asked the sports people, think of one of the best game you have ever played. And you were the hero of the game. So they were in alpha zone when they thought about it. And when you ask them, one of the worst game you have ever played, you could not concentrate, you have played badly, and because of you, the country lost the game. They straight go into beta or gamma zone, right? Because they cannot focus. But now same thing when I ask the film industry actor and actresses, you ask them the best scene you have ever done. They have been in gamma zone, and we ask them the worst scene you have ever done, they are in gamma zone. Please understand, both the times they were directed, it was not their thought. When they are acting, they are told to do what? So when they are told to do, there is a stress on them whether they would be doing it right, whether they are catching up what the director wants. So that thought, because somebody has told them, they go in a beta or gamma zone. They cannot be in alpha zone. So we have not seen a hero or a heroine thinking of a good role that they have done and being in alpha zone. Just to summarize again, to make you all understand, because I've spoken about the each zone individually. Again, delta is deep sleep and theta is dreams. Alpha, you start focusing. It also helps in healing. Beta and gamma, at present, we can say it is same. During beta, a lot of gamma you can find. And in gamma, a lot of beta you can find. So still under a lot of study to find out, but both are not good as far as if you want a sportsman to be trained. You have to bring them out from beta and gamma and push them towards alpha. This is how the display will be. Again, if you go to SLI, if you are looking at how the slide will be looking. So we are talking about alpha, beta, gamma on this zone. And this is how it will be portrayed to you when it's coming. So I'll show the next slide, it working. Now, please understand, theta and delta, that is up to 0 to 7 hertz per second. We are finding that it is increased in children because they have very active imagination and they are not able to focus. Children, you ask any child a simple question, what you want to be. It's not that they will talk about one. They will be talking about number of things. They will say they want to be an engineer. They will say a doctor. They would say so many. They will say different things. They will not say one thing. So it is one thing that is going to be. Then in alpha, it's exactly when we become adult, when we are focused and we are into an adulthood or finished our teenage, there is this alpha waves is increased in adulthood. And we have, because this is a time when we have an ability to focus, concentrate and stay alert, right? So I feel you won't find alpha in small children. It is developed or alpha comes as we grow. And then going back to as we age, we go back to theta and delta because again, that inability of focus is coming. We cannot focus on things once you become senior citizen and there's an increased access to memories. We think a lot about our old, whatever has happened, about a young age when we were in college, school, games. So because the access increases with our memories, we go back to our theta and delta waves. So there's a limited time where you can focus. That is your youth. And the time there is more of alpha. But there are ways where you can remain in alpha. We will be talking about it, how to use the technologies or meditation to remain in alpha. So we can train our brains, right? So one of the simple form is we have used audio frequencies, which are oscillating sound. They are not songs. They are not music or songs or equipments. They are more to do with echoing of certain sound, right? And so an auditory stimulus with binaural beats, pre-programmed frequency of hater. So in a single, if you have a single one on one ear, you put an or to listen to an echo to a sound. And if it is of 8 hertz, that is what is alpha. So you go in alpha zone or combination of 2 beats in your ears. So when you minus it, see, from 2 years you are listening. So the average should become 8 hertz. So one of your frequency would be 178 and other would be 170. So when you minus them, it becomes 8 hertz. That's the alpha range. So you can have, so sometimes when you are listening to music with your, in your both ears with your headphones, you have to really find out whether really it is 8 hertz. Whether, because you need proper equipments to measure it and do it. But there are certain echoes which can create that 8 hertz. So it's not a required dual. A single sound would be creating 8 hertz. Now, why sports? Why we selected sports to do this study on? Because maybe for long I was with the sportsmen with the cricket and football teams. So sports, always remember, sports is a competition. There is no sports as sports if you're not going to have matches, if you're not going to play against each other. So sports is equal to competition. And because it is competition, there is going to be constant pressure. And there always will be a fear of failure. Right? And peak performance is required for excellence in competition. So a sportsman, in short, needs to be in peak performance. If the sportsman is injured or not in peak performance, he or she is not going to perform well. So we selected sportsmen to see what we could do with their brains. This is a normal state. So I'm just showing a video, a normal sportsman, right? So we have not told them anything. We are not asking them. We are not talking to them. So they are thinking on their own. And you see how the herds, from where all they are wavering. You will find them in theta, beta, alpha, gamma. They're all over. From delta to gamma, they're all over. And both the sides, right and the left. Now you know very well what each side does. So that's how they are working. But yes, we have peak mushroom peaks also. So, which is more on the left side. Right. So, one of the instruments that we had used was Alpha Technology. It's a small earphone you can listen. They are not music, I said. They are not beats. Right. So, it is just more to do with echoing of a sound. It's an echo. Right. And you could get the same thing, the next option, if you don't get such equipments or sound to be do, you can use meditation. I always say when you pray, you talk to God. But when you meditate, God talks to you. So meditation is another form of getting into alpha zone. Still, we have to wait the pharmacology department or the pharmacist start making a medicine. So when you take that tablet, you will go in alpha zone. Hopefully, it will come soon. So let's talk about alpha. We saw that. See how alpha state will be looking. So this is of a sportsman. When the brain mapping was done, you see the prominent mushroom spikes. So they are around 8 hertz. And you can see number of them. So that's how exactly. I'll be showing it in a slide form also. This is a video form, how it will look, the sportsman being in alpha state. See, nothing on gamma, nothing on the extreme right. So nothing in beta, nothing in gamma. Thickly alpha zone. This sportsman has to do very well. In this state, if a sportsman is sent on the field, his performance is going to be excellent. Whatever game they are playing, whatever they are doing, this is the zone we want them to be in. And definitely, this is the zone we want the students to be going to examine. If you go to exam also in this state, it's going to be, you will be writing great. So a sports physiotherapist can play an important role, not only in preventing injuries to the sportsman, but treat and train and prepare the performance of getting the sportsman into alpha state, that's alpha zone, right? Before and maintain the state of mind during the game. So there are simple methods. You can talk to a sportsman if you're a personal physio of a sportsman. Maybe just by talking to them, you are putting the sportsman into alpha zone. Or they can meditate. Some of them meditate. Some of them, you know, they really keep talking to themselves. You must be seeing a lot of sportsmen, they talk to themselves. So when they are screaming, shouting, grunting, or talking to themselves, it's a way that they go to alpha state. Or they are in putting themselves in alpha zone. I very well remember, because most of the viewers now are from Maharashtra. I want to tell them, I very well remember we were playing in 1994. We were playing a game in Durban, South Africa. And we were already 4 down with just 60 runs or something on the board. And we had a new batsman going to go in first time. New player, Praveen Amre. And I saw him from morning. He was padded up and having his bat in his hand. And he was telling himself, you know, Mala Karalaich Paije, Mala Karalaich Paije, Mala Karalaich Paije. And believe me, we were down 60 runs, 4. And he went in and made 100 and came back. So his Karalaich Paije worked. So maybe he was putting himself in alpha zone. That time, no doubt, I didn't have the facilities to do a EEG on him and find out in which zone he is. But I remembered very well that he's only talking to himself that Mala Karala Spaije made him do 100 and we could save the game. So that's the zone I love. That's the zone is my passion. How to get everybody in the world on this zone is what we are looking for. It enhances healing. An injured sportsman, put him in alpha, he'll heal faster, even without treatment. Enhancing the concentration and focus to get back to the game, it helps, right? Now, Allman said very well in 1992, peak performance requires a special state of intense concentration, which is alpha activity. We call it today alpha zone. Allman said it in 1992. So please understand, it's not only for sports. It's for everything. So alpha is the zone of living. Today, the living zone should be alpha. I hope sometimes our doorbell will be in such that when you ring a doorbell and the sound should take you in alpha zone. When your mobile phone rings, the ring should be so soothing, it should take you in alpha zone. These are the future of brain mapping. So the brainwave pattern of various sportsmen was studied when in the state of consistently winning. I said in a simple way, when we asked a sportsman, okay, when they were winning, how, what was their feeling, or just to take themselves thinking of the best game they have performed, they were in alpha zone. And when they have not performed well, they were in gamma zone or beta zone, right? So the high activity in the alpha and theta range is otherwise known as the alpha state. So either it is in theta or it is going to be alpha. Alpha, theta, see the edges, you know, they are common. So we could say theta and alpha together, beta and gamma together, because they are very familiar and they're close to each other. So a few frequency here or there, unless much more studies are done on it and we come to the accuracy of the cycle per second, the hertz per second. This is what you will see on an injured sportsman, right? Or a sportsman not performing well. So it's very easy to find out whether the sportsman, because sportsmen lie. You don't know whether they're injured or not. So if you do a brain mapping and let them think whatever they want, let them think whatever they want, right? This is how it will look, because, you know, there's a constant high activities going on in the brain. They're thinking why he is doing it, why, will he find out that? Okay, this is just a case study of a cricketer. So we wanted to do a study on a cricketer. The first day knows nothing about alpha, gamma, nothing. So we just did a brain mapping to find out how he would be showing. You see all the mushrooms so prominent, right? So he was a male, so his brain state before listening to any alpha therapy or before we talking to him, if we want to get you in alpha or whatever. Nothing, what is gamma, what is alpha, not telling him anything, right? So in initial stage, no dominant wave pattern. So see, from you're getting delta, theta, but less of gamma, right? So not gamma, but we don't have prominent alpha also. So I'll show next, we brought him into alpha. So we did an alpha session, making him listen to that sound echo for 20 minutes, right? So it is very clear he goes into a deep state of alpha. So we had only asked him to concentrate and keep looking. He had to keep hearing whatever that sound was coming. Right. So very clear at 8, between 8 and 9 hertz per second, both sides, left and right. Right. Comfortable, he has entered the zone. Right. And on the right, I just want to show the different week what happened. He was regularly playing club cricket. So first week, May, he took 4 wickets for 32 runs. Then second week, we continued again, 3 runs and 3 wickets. And again, he took 2 runs and gave 40 runs. And by the month end, his career best was 6 wickets, 22 runs. Right. This was a case study to find out really whether it's going to help in sports. And I'm very sure we are entering there. This was the slide. So what we showed you, this is exactly when a sportsman is in peak performance, a person who has performed very well. Tell any cricketer the best performance, you will get a slide, something like this. You can get a brain mapping, something like this. Alpha zone. So brain mapping is going to be a tool for sports physiotherapist. Very soon it will enter sports. So as we know that a physician adds years to the life, but it's going to be a physiotherapist that will add life to the years. And I've taken that word from Quran, he who heals one of my human being has healed my mankind. That's what God tells us. And we are in a healing profession. So as far as we know healing, we heal the sportsman or in any other condition. For God, he has taken that we have healed the whole mankind. Thank you. I'm open to questions.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ali Rani, sir.
I come back. Yeah. Great. Yeah. You can stop sharing and I can come.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Over to you, Dr. Vivek Kulkarni, sir.
Am I audible?
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. So can I just make a comment before Kulkarni, sir?
Yes, sir.
So excellent lecture, Professor Irani. I was actually, to be very honest, you know, you might be monitoring my wave. So let me be honest. See, I was going to tune in for 2 minutes when you started and I was going to leave. But then every slide, it became very interesting. And I heard the whole talk. I have made notes also, I can show you. So I have made notes. So I think my question to you is very simple. So the aim is to create the alpha waves, you know, whatever you do. So you talked about it in physiotherapy. So is it the same true all across? So if I'm treating a patient for pain, for orthopedics, for better healing, is it that if I get him into the alpha mode, he
would
feel better?
Sir, we had done on a monk. We had given him a lot of, we deliberately told him this problem will not get all right, this. And we did his brain mapping. He was in gamma zone. So much stress. Then we told him, please meditate. You have been taught meditation. In 15 minutes, he was back in alpha zone. So meditation brings you.
So I think this is the way to go. You know, and you know, I always say this statement that it's all in the mind. No, as you said, that Praveen Amre's example, me karnar, me karnar, me karnar. If you keep telling that mind, and I'm a strong believer of that, then you can do it. So at that time, you're saying that your map, brain map is in the alpha zone. So I think it's a very wonderful concept. I have always heard about it, but I never gave it enough attention. But I think there's a strong correlation, you know, it's all in the mind. And
so your surgeries.
The mind, yeah. Perfect.
If you go for your surgeries, sir, with brain mapping, if you give me 10 top surgeons of Bombay, and when I ask you to imagine your best surgery you have performed, and I'll catch on what zone you were when you were doing it, I take an average of 10 people, and you get a new student. So day one, I'll tell you whether he'll become like you or not.
Oh.
10 very good MDs in the bank, 10 oh. MDs. 10 surgeons on an average will be able to focus whether student want to become a physiotherapist. So day one, you can tell them really whether he'll become a good physiotherapist or not.
So, oh. I just want to make a last comment and then I'll let you continue the discussion. I think let's take this offline. I'm very much interested to, you know, take this forward with you and, you know, see how it can help. As the last slide, you said, you know, the duty of a physician and a physiotherapist is to help mankind. And I'm sure if we can decode this particular puzzle of getting people into the alpha state, I think, you know, it'll be the best thing we can do. So with that note, I'll let Professor Kulkarni take over the further discussion. But thank you for opening my eyes.
And come someday and do it in Sanjeti Hospital, sir. We'll do it on your patient and say.
Surely, sir.
Best.
Thank you, sir. Regards. Bye-bye.
Right. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Ali. I totally agree with Parag, sir, that as and when you went on unfolding your slides, it was really catching up the attention and the interest grew much more and more. And I think probably I must have gone in the alpha zone, 100%, I can tell you, because the way it went on and the way you have put down the details, I mean, it is so surprising, and at the same time to know that how the complex network of our brain is working and how the different phases of our brains are there. You have so nicely pointed out between the left and the right, and so nicely said that a tongue can lie, but a brain cannot. Oh, that was a wonderful statement, and so true. And more so the characteristics of the different brainwave characteristics, especially when you went on correlating it with the ages, how they change and how we need to be focused and stay maximum time in alpha zone. I think we can, this brain mapping definitely has lot of scope, especially in this world of stress. You can definitely have therapeutic things to getting back to the things. And I also liked out the example of the film stars, what you gave, that how confused they are. And so nicely enhanced that how does a sportsman, when he's injured, and how rightly you can catch up. So that is absolutely fabulous that we can really pinpoint and localize where exactly the things are then. And I'm sure this, the very fact that the zone can be shifted by the thoughts, that was something very amazing, you know, where you can get in fact instant results. So again, a great lecture. And so many thoughts you have unfolded, how the waves characteristics are in children and how they grow again back to the theta and the delta in the old age because of the inability to focus. So I think a very wonderful lecture, and I'm sure it has a lot of scope. And let us see, we are looking forward to have your association, as Parag sir has rightly mentioned out, as Sancheti. Thank you, Dr. Ali, so much. Dr. Neeraj, back to you.
Thank you, Vivek Kulkarni, sir. I would like to request all the viewers, if you have any question, you can put it in on your chat box on YouTube or also on Facebook. Okay. Ali, sir, there is one question from my colleague, Dr. Manish Ray. As a neurotherapist, can this alpha and beta stage can be used in the treatment of comatose patients?
See, all the neurological condition are, I said, we have got two units. One we are exclusively using in sports and one other one in neuro. Okay. So our students have done study treating a hemiplegia, upper extremity only, okay, using brain mapping, getting the patient into alpha and treatment. Okay. The recovery and the responses were much better. And we had a student who had done for the lower extremity. Not the same patient, different patients. So in neurological condition, I feel one of the best way is reading the brain of your patient. Usually they are all in beta and gamma. And if they are on medication, then you could say that they could be on theta also. But we don't find them. We have to bring them in alpha. So when the patient comes in, and very difficult in children, because it's very difficult. You cannot give your suggestion. You cannot put suggestion. You cannot do a lot of things. So, but in neurological condition, if you get the patient in alpha and treat whatever, you are going to work hard on them for 45 minutes, 1 hour. So being in alpha, then not using it, we found tremendous result when you are putting the patient in alpha and giving the treatment.
Thank you very much, sir. Yeah. I would like to request Dr. Aparna, ma'am, second panelist.
We will be happy to hear from Dr. Aparna, her views on this particular brain mapping topic. Yeah, Dr. Aparna. I think she'll join shortly, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
So go ahead with the questions.
Yeah. She has messaged. She is having some network issues. Okay. But I think she has mentioned the question. Yeah. So her question is, when we are giving alpha therapy, does it interfere with normal electricity activity of the brain? Had this been reported?
No. See, when we are reading the activity of the brain, you are in one of the five zones. If you are asleep, you are in delta. If you are semi-conscious, you come to theta. Then you come to alpha, beta. So when you get up, when you are treating, the patient is in one of the zones. The best results will come when you are in alpha zone. We are not stimulating anyway. We are just reading in what are the activities of the brain going that time.
Okay. Yes.
Unless you use that equipment of alpha therapy. If you're using alpha therapy, it's a sound therapy. It's not music. It's right. More of an echo sound. Or we say the other way is meditation.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes. Thank you very much, sir. Yeah. So, moving on to, we'll just see any other questions from viewers. On Facebook. No. Okay. Yeah. Right now, there are no questions. But if any question they will ask, we will get back to you, sir. Definitely.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So one last question, yeah. I would like to ask. So how, Professor Irani, do you think that this can be popularized and actually being used to, you know, the masses? And I think what you rightly said, one thing is that if a tablet or something comes up, you know, there is a thin line dividing a drug versus a tablet, who, you know, which gets you into this mood. So it will be actually a very good thing to experiment and get that right titration.
The government should allow. I would ask people to try many things and find out in which one takes them. It's very easy to find out. There is a lot of study happening with cannabis, but I've not got a patient who will use cannabis. And if I do it, maybe he is in alpha zone.
So I think, but what happens with all this is that you never know when he's going to go to the beta or gamma. So
yeah, yes.
So I think that's the challenge. So I think
the dosage will decide.
Yeah, that will be the exact future. And
our main scare is this is a tool. How you are going to use it?
Very well said.
You use it well. It will help the sportsmen like anything. Put them in that zone and send them to bat.
Absolutely. I think, you know, that is why people, you know, talk about these drugs and all these things and doping. So I think it has to be something which the NADA is not going to oppose. And at the same time, it's going to be officially allowed.
The IIT students, many of them take and go for exam. 3 hours paper, they finish in 2 hours, come and they are 80 plus marks. So the activity must be going to that level.
Yeah, I think the future beholds a lot of...
So the pharmacy should step in now and see what they can give.
Absolutely. Yeah, perfect. So, Neeraj, on that note, I think we can conclude the first webinar. It went extremely well. I'm so happy that I'm a part of the first webinar of Physio TV. Yes.
And thank you, sir.
Very, very well done. An excellent topic. I'm sure this particular webinar is going to go viral on the YouTube. And Dr. Ashok, it is your responsibility to ensure that happens. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you,
Dr. Rao. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Truly, it's an amazing topic. And I think people have gone to gamma zone thinking about it, I think. Yeah. So, exactly. So, here, I would like to thank all the viewers also, as well as today's eminent speaker, Dr. Ali Irani, sir, for sharing his knowledge and exposure with all the especially in this such a crucial time. We wish all our audience healthy and safe days ahead, and we hope these webinars add value to your time.
So on this Thanksgiving, I would like to extend my warm gratitude towards Dr. Parag Sancheti sir to backing up all of us for this first webinar of this Physio TV. Also, I would like to thank Dr. Ashok Sham sir for being helpful hand in this technical aspects, as well as Mr. Rahul Chaubey, Dr. Apurva Shimpi sir, Mr. Dr. Manish Ray, Dr. Nilima ma'am, Nilima Bedekar ma'am. I would like to thank all of this for their great help achieving in this first Physio TV webinar. Thank you all.
May I request Dr. Ashok Sham to please say a few words on his vision for Physio TV? Since I think it's the first webinar, it is only apt and appropriate for you to say something. He never says something, Professor Irani. I'm just putting him in a spot. So hopefully he says something today.
Thank you, sir. And first of all, I'd like to thank Dr. Ali Irani for that excellent talk. And it was really eye-opening for us orthopedic surgeons. So thank you very much, sir. And we'd like to know more about how physiotherapy branch is growing and prospering and the recent updates about it. And like sir said, our vision is to bring all physiotherapists around the world on this platform. So vision is a global physiotherapy network, a global platform where all physiotherapists can share their knowledge and also acquire new knowledge. So I think that is the future where we all come together on one platform or multiple platforms online and share our knowledge, share our wisdom, and share all the research and academic activities. So that's the whole vision, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Ashok. Thanks
Thank
for sharing
you, your Thank voice. You, sir. All the best.
Hello, sir. Yes. Thank you, sir. There is one question from audience on YouTube. May I tell this? Dr. Ali, sir?
We will just take this last question and then end.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. We'll take the last question. So the viewer wants, what is the neurophysiology behind this?
Let's read EEG.
Okay.
The way ECG was formed to know how your heart functions, EEG was made to see how your brain functions. And I did it in a layman's language. So I've not gone through the medical terms. I wanted everybody to understand because most of the viewers were the students. So made brain very simple, how many zones it is. These zones have been studied by our students. All have read papers. All are documented.
Thank yes. Thank you, Dr. Ali Irani.
Thank you. And all the best for Physio TV.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
So, yeah.